Welcome back to Let's Play Jogun Gold, and we're going to continue exploring the inside of the pyramid. First, we leap into the pit. Here we are at the Pit of Death. This is where we found the Amulet of Ra, and we went left. This time we're going to go right. And this is the entrance to a giant pit called the Big Hollow. And it's somewhat annoying because if you fall down, you have to climb all the way back up. It's quite a chore. I'm used to it, and if I do accidentally fall down, I will climb back up, but I will skip all the climbing. Here you have to kind of make a leap of faith. I forget exactly where. Oh no, we're alright. And there's a skeleton down there. Let's check that out. Find an item, piece of sun disk. And actually, I shouldn't have gone this way. Let's fall all the way down. This skeleton here, you found a lapis lazuli ankh. That is this other seal ankh. Remember that room said, you know, do not enter without seal ankhs? That was plural? Well, now we have two of them. And that's good enough. And is there anything in here? Nair! Let's do some climbing. Oh, these are cables. You can sort of climb back and forth on these. But you can only get on them at very specific points. And you can't climb up them. You can't climb down them. You can just sort of only get on and off if you're at floor level. Like, I can get on that. But if I'm falling down, there's no way I can possibly reach them. We're not going in there just yet. No, we're going up here. And there's a button. Now, this button opens a secret door on the left side of the Big Hollow. We're not going to go back there for some time, but it's open now. That's convenient. Oh, now here, almost immediately your character just automatically grabs on. You have to kind of let go to make this jump. And there's that little lone skeleton way over there. That's a hint as well, but we're not going to be dealing with that just yet. No, we're going all the way up here. You can also get back the way you came. See, there's the ceiling we can climb along, but no, we want to go up the ladder. That's strange, I got stuck there. Never happened before. The third sarcophagus here has a socket. You hear rumbling, and that has opened up another door for us. But before that, jump into the wall. And they sort of have to climb up and down and up and down. Another golden mask, we're up to 5, we've found half of them. Well, the game doesn't tell you how many there are. There are 10. Back down we go. Oh, and I've screwed up. Let's see if I can... Yeah, we can recover from this. Aha! See where that skeleton is? Now there's a thingy, a passage, secret room. Well, we have to kind of jump around to get there. I am not overly fond of this area because of all of this jumping around. Piece of the sun disk. I forget how many pieces we have. And now that we've got all that, we are going to go to the right. Hang on, I'm just checking my map. Ah, now here we have lots of spikes. There's spikes there, there's spikes there, there's spikes there. And you're like, well, how am I supposed to get to the exit ladder? Again, there's a hidden button. No indication that it's there. And you basically walk into this dead end here. And with that, one of the spikes no longer pops up. That's sad. Again, you can only figure this out by experimentation. Oh, remember? This is hard to get out unless we use the... Where is it? Book of the Living. Everything is silent. And now these guys are totally safe. Oh, more climbing. Yeah, this is just... This entire room is just climbing and climbing. Actually, you hang onto these wires and you can climb right underneath that particular block. This one, I'm gonna save the game state again. There are four buttons here, and there's this boulder going back and forth. And it's a little bit of a matter of timing and experimenting with the buttons. And if you mess it up, you just leave the room, you come back. So the first thing you want to do is you want to get this top button while... See, these buttons create gaps that open up. And you want to get that boulder into that little passage on the bottom right, where there's one last button. Now, I believe the next one we do is this one, like so. It's very easy to get the boulder trapped accidentally. Let me see here. I get this one. Yep, and then this one. Alright. Hey, more stuff. Now in here, we have bricks we can break. So for that, we need the hammer. Where's the hammer? There's the hammer. Does this guy have anything? No. And I'm trapped, if not for the hammer. Sort of break my way out of here. There we go. Hammer up here. Golden mask number 6. The levers. You know, there's nothing in this room. It's just, you know, two sarcophagi placed together kind of suggests there was a story. Or the guy was just running out of things to name the rooms. I like it. It adds atmosphere. Uh-oh, another boulder. And there's ways to escape it. This skeleton. Leather whip. No, Indy, you died. As far as I know, there's actually no use for the leather whip. It's just a little tribute to Indiana Jones. Okay, we can escape across the ceiling. And actually, this will bring us all the way. We can get out of the pit to the other side this way. But we're not going that way. We're going to drop down. We're going to get that golden mask. Actually, no, we do have to go back up, come to think of it. Because we need to go to the room that requires the ankh, and we can only do that from the other side of the pit. Okay. All right. Here we go. Seal chamber. Enter with seal ankhs only. Now, remember we turned off the undead. Now we need to turn them back on. I like it. It's like a remote for zombies. Book of the Dead. Presses the button, and in we can go. Now, again, it's a good idea if you're using an emulator, if you can save your state, because once you're in here, you can't get back out. Unless you have the ankhs. See, now this is happening automatically. I'm not controlling the character at this point. You went too far already. Give up and leave. Or die here and now. And the door is closed behind us. And whoa, snakes everywhere. It is possible to get through this without the flute. It's just kind of tricky. Flute, where are you? There you are. Here, what do we have? An ankh-shaped hole. And I think the left one is lapis lazuli. It fits perfectly, and suddenly there's like this shaft of purple light. And you can avoid the snakes now just by hopping across the top platforms. Ruby Ankh, you think you have won. This is not the end yet. We will meet again. Okay, leave the room, come back, the snakes are gone. And we can pick up this. You found an item, Feather of Horus. And we can read what's on these doors. I don't know what the proper reading order is. So I think I've got them in an order here that kind of makes sense. Eons ago, Anubis reigned in terror. Okay, so Anubis, guardian of the land of the dead in Egyptian mythology. Not a nice guy. Pharaoh led a battle and locked Anubis away. For him to never unleash his wrath again. His power was broken, and a seal invoked. And the seal was guarded. Pharaoh has reigned ever since. I don't really know if that helps solve any puzzles. It's just a bit of backstory, I suppose. Let's fall back down the pit. And climb up to the right. And now fall down. And that is the passage that we opened with the button that was on the far right of the big hollow. Another golden mask. We are up to 8. And we go back down again. To the right. And I didn't mention this ladder. This is the entrance to the end game. And the music has changed, and we will do the end game in the next video. It may take 2. Anyway, see you then.